get the punt, that's a must, I don't trust.
Oh cool, okay, oh cool, in Tokyo, I'm with my goals, my shooters up, no Liverpool, in Tokyo.
Hey y'all, what's up? Now I'm ready to come back at you with another reaction video. As y'all can see, I got some special guests with me. State y'all name.
Soraya.
Madison.
Brooklyn.
Today we're going to be reacting to 14 horror stories animated. It's an hour long, but we ain't got time to watch all day, so we're going to watch like 30 minutes of it. And we hope y'all enjoy because we scared. Yeah, we are.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we are. But we're going to get right into this and let go. True horror story.
I was 13 when this happened. My parents left on a business trip to LA, so I had to stay home. My dad gave me his card so that I could order whatever I needed. So I kind of enjoyed it.
For real.
I got milk on it.
And I wasn't scared.
Look at what she eating. That's a Pop-Tart.
Alone so many times. And besides, it was only for 3
Look at Coke bottle.
Well, this was around the time the clowns were breaking into houses and doing some weird stuff.
Yeah, I missed
but they
it!
They came to my area since they usually hit more quiet places, especially the area near a forest. Although we had a fence that could easily allow someone to climb over, we didn't really think much about it because the area where we lived in was
like
very
10.
Safe.
You would have been, man,
anyway,
would have been fighting.
It was around 6 p.m. and this was in the winter, so it got dark pretty fast. We had a glass room at the back of the house.
How's the glass black?
A conservatory, and it leads straight to the garden.
This will be scary.
This was green.
The room was right next to the kitchen. I got a little hungry. So I went to the fridge, took out some snacks, and went back to the living room to continue watching TV. There was a roof on the
floor that
intensified any sound that landed on top of it, even the gentlest drop of water. That day, it was raining heavily, so it was too noisy to hear anything except the rain was pounding on the roof. About a few minutes later, I was quite sleepy. So I decided to go up to my room and lay down. I was about to grab my phone and check my social media, but then I
heard
someone drop really hard.
Look at your own phone. Oh, she got scared!
It really creeped me out. I got really scared, but decided to go downstairs to check, thinking that it would be nothing. So I came out of my room, went halfway down the staircase,
and
down the hallway. The whole area was dark, but I knew that someone was standing in the
sunlight.
I quickly went in, trying not to make any
noise. Oh my god,
I'm gonna come back here.
Oh my god, I didn't stop that mother.
I immediately called the police and whispered to the operator that I needed help ASAP. But all of a sudden, I had a sneezing fit. I was so panicked at that moment, so I instantly ran to the bathroom since it was the only room.
Being loud!
As I was reaching the bathroom, he sprinted up the stairs so fast. I locked the door and tried not to.
Look at this, wait.
The man tried to open the door. He kept turning the doorknob. The bathroom had a small, blurry window, but I was able to see outside. So, just then, I got a glimpse.
Now we looking none like that shadow.
With green hair and without
noise. Put down my head!
But that's how I'm like Joker, y'all.
No, stop. Okay, I'm done.
Opened the big window and jumped out. I slid on the fence, I heard the cops. They entered our house, and after that, they arrested
him.
When he walked past me, I was so scared, and my body was shivering. But I was glad that it was over. The police contacted my parents, so they
got
home in a hurry.
Oh my god.
I would see them again. And I knew
we should have left you at home.
Then,
that's how they be. We should have
never stayed at home alone. And that was in prison for several
years. If we be by ourselves, we're going to be with our siblings. Imagine on the video.
For possible murder.
I gave him candy. Someone tried to open my car.
This happened when I was 17 years old.
I was a senior.
He cross-eyed it.
Like, I can't do it. It was the middle of the year. My friends and I were chatting online about
that's what sucks that he's in.
Doing fun over the weekend. We usually just went to the movies, went to the mall, or got dinner. And I thought we should try something different.
Look at his fingers in the back.
The next day, I was in the computer
and then he had a little mukbang, which you're going to share.
Keep in mind, Snapchat and Instagram were just starting up and didn't have the same kind of popularity as it has today.
What's going to watch the video?
We really had Snapchat, at the time was Instagram. Facebook. However, my school was strict.
No Facebook.
So the only thing I could really do was read articles on news websites.
Sorry, y'all, didn't even pay attention to the video.
Searching and scrolling through
the internet. They went to the juicy stuff happened, but I'm watching all through.
It was about an interview with a man who was discussing the truth of paranormal activity around the area I grew up in.
I watched it. Come
on. Intrigued, I read the article and looked up the places the guy was talking about. Sure enough, I found a bunch of things. One place in particular caught my eye. It was a place about 20 minutes away from where I lived. It was known to have multiple paranormal occurrences happen on the exact same road. When class ended, I texted my friends about what I found, and we all agreed on going and seeing what this road was all about Friday night.
Oh, sounds exciting.
Friday night finally
arrived. Yeah, guys, party in my house. I don't even know where they're going. I haven't played attention. Right, oh, they're in the woods. You know they'll never be good.
I parked my car and had my friend drive. Because we believe that if a guy drove,
in the woods,
not much would happen.
Girl, they're talking about the road.
So she drove my car while I was sitting in the car.
We're not in like State Line Road.
While switching
like seats, look like Church Road.
Wait, this is what it looked like.
When ghosts touch or brush your car. It started to drizzle a bit, which bummed us out because the
baby
powder would be washed
off. It might be State Line.
No, I think it's stable because they have a
car. We turned off the radio to make it more suspenseful.
My boomers.
All of a sudden,
no, it's over there. No, like,
I told you to stop doing it. What they scream for?
Like, open, as if someone was
trying to get into my car.
After that, we saw a police car driving so fast with the sirens on, as if they were chasing someone on a major highway.
Who tried to open his door while they were driving? It had been those.
Had tons of sharp turns.
Yeah, couldn't you see somebody?
He couldn't go that fast without crashing into another car. Plus, the car didn't.
Why they looking at the road? They're like,
Mexican.
From the area I lived in. I knew that because my dad was a cop, and I saw all kinds of different cops in my life.
They good.
I was.
They all scared. Look at the girl in the back seat.
Just occurred.
We were all freaked out.
I drove to the nearest parking lot. So
look where he is!
Pull over and beat the show.
As we got out of the car, one of my friends started to freak out even more.
What's that?
The baby powder on the roof of my car was smeared, and it was all over my passenger seat side door.
Shoot!
Is that milk?
What was even baby powder. Creepy was the fact that there were finger marks all over the door.
They're not just finger marks. They're my handprints.
It normally freaked me out. But we were driving the entire time, and we all made sure not to touch the doors when entering the car. The strangest part was that the finger marks had no fingerprints, but were clearly shaped like a hand.
What?
It was as if someone was trying to reach for the door handle.
And you go, baby.
Not only that,
a demon baby?
We also noticed that there were
demon babies like Granny. No, Slenderina, dog.
This freaked me out because earlier I heard someone violently trying to open my door.
That's stupid.
Open this door! Open your door!
Both online and in person that night, and how it freaked us all out. Then someone
and obviously they freaked out that much. You still drive? I mean, on the computer.
And all the activity that occurred on it, but it wasn't the one I originally read. It was a different one. As I was reading the
website, stop trying to go investigate. Leave it alone. It ain't got nothing to do with you.
Also happened to me the same exact way that night.
Okay, well, you shouldn't try to do it. Anyway,
what
next.
What freaks me out the most to this day is
next caller.
Next caller. We ain't talking about nothing. Grandma watched the video. Yeah, I ain't talking about nothing.
Yeah, that's scary.
That's really scary.
That's creepy. She's calling a true horror story about the man who snuck into our house. Oh, Lord. Y'all already know how this
it's
gonna go.
It's true.
It's gonna be jump scares after jump scares. We already
yep, know. Sure is.
And don't scream. Oh, I almost broke my bed.
I started watching these on my phone.
2017.
We watching them on here.
I'm
going to sleep.
My older brother and I had a babysitter.
Before we went to bed
she was around the age of 17. Since my mom was home on Tuesday, the babysitter would come on the other weekdays. Most days when she babysat, we would go to the neighborhood pool, hang out, and eat lunch.
That burger ain't that good.
Then we went back home, and my mom would arrive a bit later at around 5:30 in the evening.
I'm on feet.
On one Thursday, the day
was the video, dummy.
And the babysitter came around 8 in the morning.
Why would I like that?
A few hours later, we decided to head to the pool and eat lunch. We all got ready.
It was like it was a man character, a boy character, and they just put a wig on top.
Paranoid back then. Every time I went outside, I made sure I locked the door.
Look at
and would immediately
you saw that TikTok? I don't want another pretty face. Sure I don't want
locked.
Just anyone.
The door was definitely locked. So we walked to the pool.
See, they looked exactly the same.
Then we ate lunch and decided to head back to the house. When we got home, I pulled out the key from my bag, but I noticed that the door was a crack open. I pushed it, and the door swung open.
A
little chill ran down my spine as I remembered that I made sure the door was locked before leaving. My babysitter had a frightened look on her face, too.
Look at her!
My stupid brother thought nothing of it and just walked right in.
See?
So we
followed him. When you put grease on your hair, it make it look
about my house, when you walk into the house, to the right is an entryway to the living room. And straight ahead is a hallway to the kitchen. The stairs are to the right of the hallway, and you can see the upstairs railing from the entrance. We walked into the kitchen and set our stuff down, and I went to go back the door. After I shut it, I turned back around to go back to the kitchen, but something caught my attention at the corner of my eye. Looking up at the railing, I could see the silhouette of someone crouched behind a tall, narrow
floor.
The window was staring directly at me.
I would have screamed at the top of my lungs.
All I could see was
Okay, stop now. You're gonna lose your voice.
My babysitter called for me to come to the kitchen, and the figure slowly walked into a nearby room and disappeared. I ran into the kitchen,
Sorry, I can't really see Madison. She's trying to watch the video, but
at first they didn't believe me. But then, all of a sudden, we were all silent as we heard slow footsteps creaking from upstairs. She quietly grabbed both her phone and a kitchen knife and ushered us to the back door. She slowly turned the doorknob and tried to not make anyone
mind your toes outside. Right,
we made it to the backyard, and she was going to call 911 on her phone. But before she
could,
we heard a tapping sound coming from one of the windows on the second floor. So we all looked up. And then we
saw a man, blade-faced, short black hair,
eyes still wide open, staring at us.
He had a blind.
He was pushing the blinds out of the way, so we saw his face very clearly. We screamed and started running to the gate on the side of the
Oh, she gone! Drop the phone.
So I picked it up.
Don't scream!
911.
What are you doing? She doing this?
Her mouth like a wall.
Explained to the operator what happened. She said they would be there in a few minutes.
They'll be there in a few minutes.
And stay there until the cops arrive.
Stay there.
We rang a doorbell a few times, and one of our neighbors, who was retired, came outside. He let us in, and we explained what happened as we were looking out of the window. Then we saw three cop cars pulling up, and the cops were surrounding my home. Three cops headed in through the front door and investigated our house.
Yeah, but it seemed like they were running for a long way, but they had to park there by the neighbors.
Soon the cops came back after finding nothing and doing a thorough investigation. They told us it would be best to not stay home. So the babysitter said we could go to her house, which is about a mile away.
Then he gonna follow you.
Our neighbors screaming from down the street. A few houses down, A policeman's car was set on fire and was smoking a lot.
Smoking.
The cops spotted a man running past the corner down towards the end of the street.
Wow.
One officer took us to the babysitter's house, while the other three went after the neighbors. We later found out that the man had gotten away, so he never got arrested. Our parents are.
If he was black, they would have had him already. Yeah. So they trying to shoot.
Didn't do too much.
Later that night,
well, I think he's
Hispanic.
Anything was missing. A cash box that was stored in my parents' bedroom was missing, but we didn't report it since the man was never found.
Still should have reported it.
I have no idea who that was or how he opened our front door. I still wonder to this day what would have happened if I never noticed the man.
No, I think
he could have done something to us while we were sleeping.
Nope.
I still feel uneasy sometimes when I'm home alone.
I will too.
What is that?
Ugly.
He's
yellow.
He's no. I realize that my best friend doesn't exist anymore.
No discrimination. Dude.
It all started one summer afternoon in August.
He says, look.
My best friend Mike invited me to his house.
No offense.
Mike was the type of kid you call a nerd. He always got good grades, wore glasses, had freckles, and believed in things like dragons and magic. One of Mike's favorite things to do was performing magic for me. Every time I'd come over, he'd perform magic. But this magic trick, though, would be the one that I'd never forget.
Bravo!
When I got to Mike's house, he said, I have a new magic trick to show you, and it's the best one. He grabbed my hand, and we went into the living room,
where
he had a large box in front of his family photo.
He said, come on, grab my hand.
It was all four of his family members in that picture. Mike, Josh, and his mom and dad. The box was about his size, so we could fit
cool, ain't it?
And his older brother, Josh, was standing next to it. So, I sat down on a couch, and Mike started introducing the name of his magic trick. It was called The Vanishing.
The Vanishing.
Josh opened the door to the large box where nothing was inside, and Mike walked in. After Josh closed the door again, he then said some weird words and then yelled, poof! Josh slowly opened the box, and Mike was no longer in it. However, I was in the seventh grade, so I was smart enough to know that under the box was a trap door so he could climb down out of it. So I looked down at the bottom of the box, but to my surprise, nothing was there.
Mm-hmm.
No door, no secret,
no
light.
This doesn't make you go to sleep.
Just at that moment, my mom called and said that I need to come home right now. I said bye to Josh, grabbed my backpack, and yelled, nice trick, Mike, gotta go. Everything was fine. Just until the next day.
Yeah, you can record.
The next day,
too.
Mike didn't invite me.
Yeah, but it's gonna end
but I thought of going to his house again. I ran up to his house, stood in front of the door, and rang the doorbell 3 times. His dad came out and said, oh, hello. Nice to meet you. He acted like that he'd never seen me before. It was weird, but I asked, good afternoon, sir. Is Mike home? Then I could see his confused face, and he answered, Mike? Who was Mike?
Wait,
I felt stupid at that moment
as if
I had come to the wrong house.
You're not your son?
I then quickly asked, your son Mike, you have 2 sons. During explaining the situation, I felt irritated, so I pushed him to the side to get into the living room.
That's wrong.
Josh,
you
I said, pointing
you back
to the photo, and then my eyes widened.
What?
Mike wasn't in the photo.
So he wasn't
real? I was
pointing
to nothing. Which would have been where Mike should be standing in that picture.
I didn't get an explanation.
I panicked, and I couldn't believe
what was
going on here. I then said, you're your son, Mike. He has good grades, and he's good at magic. Oh, the box. I thought that everyone was playing a prank with me or something, but he looked extremely confused and even terrified. He looked at me as if I was some kind of lunatic. So I ran upstairs to check the box. And I opened the door, thinking that I must be dreaming. The room was full of bookshelves and beanbags, all in a circle. It was just a cozy reading room. I was horrified.
Don't scream.
He kept saying no.
Why are your face so dramatic? I'm not, but they're dramatic.
That moment, Josh came in the room. I thought, this is the last chance. I quickly took out my phone, thinking that I could remind Mike to them by showing selfies that I took with Mike before.
I'm trying to hang
However,
in
However, just what I did, he was in none of the pictures.
So.
The one where I gave him a hug, where we went to the other friend's birthday party and took a picture with the clown.
I'm so lost.
Nothing was there.
I'm guessing.
It was like he never
existed. I think he wasn't real. Before. He was just a
little. He don't exist.
That but he went to somebody's house.
A nightmare.
You know that movie?
To this day, there is literally no one who remembers Mike in my town. I still can't believe what happened to Mike, but I definitely believe that Mike is real.
He gonna pop up.
And he must be somewhere.
So what do you mean? Always trying to pop up in
always.
The window.
I heard the panel. Alright guys, this is going to be the last one we'll watch.
My name is Kyla.
I hope y'all enjoy it so far.
This story is about a piano that was in my elementary school.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, my friends and I used to record random videos in my school's basement. Most of the time,
who's gonna go down to school? I don't care.
Them
schools be haunted.
All of them. Every school haunted.
And the reason was that place was scary and sometimes smelled really
bad. Y'all, these teachers told us some crazy stuff that happened at their school building. They said it was pranks.
We slowly walked in the basement with our phone lights.
At HLIS?
Yeah, they said somebody died in the
locker. I was nervous, but my friends were already walking ahead of me, so I just followed them.
Somebody got hanged, like it was a prom night one day, and somebody was
hanged and stuff in the back. I shouldn't be scared since I was
really happy. It's like, it's like I got blood on their skulls and stuff, but then it dropped
in. Since he was the bravest, and also the one recording on his phone.
But it probably did happen. I just watched the video.
That's a long time ago. And holding onto my friend Kate's shirt.
Me,
I don't know about your shirt. Well, I ain't going back to that school,
so and inside of it was a grand piano.
Middle school.
Nothing else.
I thought it was
the piano.
More like middle school.
We went inside that room first. We were all
they
walk quiet,
like this.
And
they look stupid.
Look how old is that? They're like that in second grade.
The basement. But we didn't hear anything. And then, out of nowhere, the rug was dead. Boring.
Look at her hair though. I think she's black.
It took us around 3 minutes to reach the end of the basement. Michael put his phone back in his pocket and we all started walking back.
The boy in the blue shoes.
We finally turned to the main gate of our school and sat on a bench. Everyone was focused on Michael as he pulled out his phone and started playing the recording. It was quiet at first, and then all that could be heard were our whispers as we tried to figure out whether or not we should continue with the recording. And then, all of our eyes widened when we heard a sound coming from what seemed like just beside the basement. We couldn't believe what we just heard.
Wait, what the? I didn't hear nothing.
Paused the video, rewinded it, and played it again. The sound came from the grand piano. It was playing a creepy song, and at that moment, Michael almost dropped his phone.
That been dramatic.
We were all
see.
Shocked and scared.
Can we see?
We didn't say anything for a while. I'm 100% positive that we didn't hear that piano playing as we walked through the basement. It was definitely quiet. And the scariest thing was that the piano was still playing when Michael said, "Boring." The recording was around 3 minutes long, and when the recording was done playing, we were all speechless. This was many years ago, but to this day, I still don't have an explanation.
Now we're showing it grown.
Maybe someone went to that room and played it.
Oh, there was
so, maybe why couldn't jacket. We hear it while we were walking through the basement?
Eye. Oh, how is it?
We also didn't see anything.
A bomb? Okay.
It's like mine.
And why did we only hear it when we played the recording?
I'm still getting this.
I am still confused about that incident.
Ooh, this weird just showed.
Okay, we can watch this. I can't believe what this stranger did. This is going to be the last one for the video. I thought the last one was going to be, but this kind of sucky.
I was at home with my boyfriend, Dan, watching TV.
Sucky.
Dan was deeply concentrated on what the TV screen was showing. So I was about to start making a romantic atmosphere.
Uh-oh.
But then I heard a knock at the door.
They're about to get in. Get into it.
I got pissed off as it interrupted, but got up anyway and opened the door.
No homophobic comments.
We lived with one of our friends, so at the moment, I thought it would be my friend. But to my surprise, it was a man around the same age as me.
He looked older than you.
He looked a little bit tired and was forcing a smile on his face. He was all sweating, and his eyes were red as if from crying. But it wasn't my business to ask. Oh, hello. The stranger said with a wide smile, taking his hand out from the shake. Hi, I said, looking at his hand and back at him. Can I use your bathroom, please?
You can pee outside.
Still having this huge smile plastered on his face.
I'm saying, you can pee outside.
Before I could say anything, though, Dan came behind me and told the guy that, indeed, he could use the bathroom. The man went in there, and Dan and I just went back to the couch and waited for him. Then I heard some sounds, like water pouring in the bathtub.
I'm just playing.
After 10 minutes, I slowly started to get curious, as he didn't come out yet. I told Dan that I should check on him. So I just waited, and 20 minutes later, he didn't come out.
That is the man.
There was just silence in the bathroom.
He probably killed himself.
After 30
he probably
minutes,
killed
well, Dan decided
that
he'd
check
the bathroom.
Oh, he probably did that so Dan can go to jail.
Having a bad feeling, I went along with him just to be sure that nothing happened to him. Hey, is everything all right? I knocked at the door at the bathroom.
Man, busting that door, that's your bathroom.
All right. I repeated the actions, but this time I knocked louder and yelled. Dan told me to wait a little longer, but I refused. I pressed on the handle of the door, expecting it to be locked, but to my surprise, it wasn't. I couldn't
don't scream.
What I saw in front of me. To my horror, there was blood splattered on the floor everywhere, and the bathtub was filled up with a red liquid, as well with a lifeless body in it.
Killed himself.
The smell of blood filled the bathroom, and I wondered how I couldn't smell that outside.
Why you killed yourself? Why?
I told Dan to call 911.
Don't touch nothing.
Over to the body to check his pulse.
Okay.
But when I got closer to it, I noticed a razor.
Stop!
What are you looking?
He could have
did it
outside. It's just dead.
Don't put
this one doing somebody
else.
Put
his name.
A razor. The 911 arrived with the cops.
Wait, I thought they know him.
Took his body, and we had to give our report.
No way,
like.
It's kind of weird because his spirit probably would be in the bathroom.
Oh, he's dead!
Especially, I'm positive that letting a stranger use your bathroom is not safe and just nonsense.
No, it ain't safe. You should have known that already.
We would have been moved out.
Ever.
What y'all think about that video? Give me y'all opinion. Ryan, you go first.
I
don't know. Was it
scary? Kind of.
Yeah, kind of, because you was...
Can I make it wasn't really scary. Yeah. It could have been scarier.
These probably based on true stories.
Some are probably based on true stories because some of this stuff actually do be happening. Mm-hmm. But y'all, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. Obviously, we didn't because we were scared. Because I'll make you scared.
I was scared. You just.
I was just being dramatic so I can get y'all to get scared. But yeah, that's the end of the video. I hope y'all. That's the end of the video.
Make sure you
like, comment,
and subscribe.
And I'm gonna see y'all next time.
Bye bye.